Welcome to the history class.
Today we are going to continue with lesson 4, protest movement against colonial rule. And before going through the lesson, we will discuss the objectives of the lesson. The objectives are to discuss Indigo Uprising of 1859, to discuss Deccan Riots of 1875, and to discuss the Munda Uprising of 1899 to 1900. In our last session, we had already discussed about Indigo Uprising and Deccan Riots, and in this session we will discuss about the Munda Uprising of 1899 and 1900. Before going ahead, we will discuss the new terms of the lesson. Aborigines, a person, animal or plant that has been in a country or region from earliest times. Kuntkati, collective ownership of land. Deserted, to leave a place. Baptize, admit someone to a particular religion. Resistance, to oppose someone or something. Liberate, to free someone. Moneylender, a person whose business is lending money to others who pay him interest. The Munda Uprising took place in 1900. The Mundas lived in and around Hazaribagh and Ranchi districts of Bihar. So they belonged to Bihar. They were a tribal community. Peasants' tribal community of Bihar. They used to believe that land was a gift of God, so people had full right on the land, so they have started their own ownership of land system called as Kuntkati, which we have discussed in the new terms. These Mundas used to trust on the German missionaries. Mundas trusted the German missionaries. They believed that the German missionaries would save them from zamindars, forced labor and colonial land revenue policy of the British government. The Mundas were not happy with the British land revenue system. They were annoyed with the exploitation done with them by the moneylenders, and they were also not happy with the zamindars' treatment with them. The land revenue system at that time was very high. It was permanent settlement which was there in Bihar. According to that, the fixed land revenue have to be paid by the peasants, and if they were not able to pay this fixed land revenue, then they could not work on their respective lands. So taking advantage of this situation, the moneylenders used to cheat and exploit the peasants. Moneylender used to lend money at very high rate of interest to the poor peasants, and as a result there was transfer of land from peasants to moneylender. And zamindar also used to exploit the Mundas. They used to collect more land revenue as it was fixed by the British government. Already the land revenue was very high and fixed, but the zamindars used to collect even more land revenue, and the Munda peasants were uneducated. They were not knowing what was the exact amount of the land revenue, so they were paying the high land revenue. Annoyed by the three segments of society who were exploiting them, in 1881, under the leadership of John the Baptist, the Mundas set up a kingdom at Dosa, and some of the German missionaries also were not happy when they set up a kingdom at Dosa. So the Mundas conquered and claimed on Chota Nagpur without the help of the German missionaries. The colonial officers of the British government, the agents who were there between the local zamindars and the peasants, the local zamindars as well as the Christian missionaries joined hands to crush the power of Mundas. They all got together against the Mundas. The Mundas were led by a local leader called as Birsa Munda. This on your screen, you are seeing the picture of Birsa Munda. He used to believe that all land belonged to Mundas and they should fight to liberate those lands from the British government. So under the leadership of Birsa Munda, the Mundas started revolt with their old or primitive weapons like axe, bow and arrows. They attacked even on the police station and government officers. The Birsa Munda, who was their local leader, was arrested and he died in jail. At last, the government accepted the demands of the Mundas and accepted the Kuntkati system of the Mundas. If you want to explore more on this topic, just go through this YouTube link And after going this YouTube link, just go through these questions which we have covered in chapter 4. In our last session, we have covered what were the causes of Indigo Revolt. And in this session, we have covered the topic, discuss how the Mundas were exploited by the moneylenders. I hope you have understood till here with the help of this explanation and notes. Your advice to make the notes of the above topic. Thank you.